Hello, this is Taureor and welcome back to Let's Play Europa Universalis IV as Poland in our Polish Domination campaign. And we're nearing the end of the game, I'm fighting everybody at the same time. And now I'm contemplating if I should declare war on Great Britain when our truce is over, so that we could get Westphalia to fight us. But I decided that it's not worth the, worth the effort, because using the same resources and the same time frame, we could conquer probably a few countries in the east, instead of just one in Europe. So, let's get on with it. We are currently fighting Persia and Bukhara here. And we're doing pretty well, although the fort system means that we have to do it gradually and slowly. I'll unpause now and see how we do. I am refraining from converting provinces for now, because we did have some rebels. Well, not really rise up, but threaten to rise up. Rise up. Colony self-sustaining. Wonderful. And we have no more colonies to settle. See? I mean, there are some in Africa, but we are not bordering them, and I'm not going into Africa. If I neglected North America, we would probably have most of Eurasia right now and Africa. But yeah, again, we colonized all of the Americas. Focusing on that. Oh, I unpaused. Yeah, what I should do now is deactivate the policy that gives us the bonus colonist. It's over here. Here we go. Because we don't need it anymore. I could take a military one. Instead, manpower modifier, leader maneuver. I'll take this. Yearly army tradition. Because why the hell not? More army tradition gives us better armies. And that's very important. Let's continue. Oh, what happened? Right, our king died. And we lost some stability. We lost two stability because he died in battle. I shouldn't have made him a general. I will actually increase stability. I will increase stability using the points. We can afford it. Oh, I should be coining those places because they are our colonies. Yeah, because I'm not going to be coining all the provinces that we'll take. We will take them by the end of the game, and we won't core them. We'll just make ourselves huge, like I did with Byzantium. Well, Byzantium went a bit better because I didn't colonize everything. Yeah. My next game will certainly not be something colonial. We might do Ottomans and just take everything, and then if we have time, some colonies. Or maybe something smaller. You know, start as one province minor and then conquer all of this. Definitely not going colonial again. Might play Ming. Haven't played the Ming for a very long time. But as Ming, you do have to go colonial usually. Okay, enough deliberations. Let us continue. Can I move into some of those territories? I could, but we would have to go around. Let's not do that. I'll just stay here for now. There is a fort here. I will go and start sieging it. And I will actually send this army to help with that siege. Sieges are going slowly because the army composition is not perfect here. We do have the manpower and the money, so I will create another army for our forces. This one. 40, 10, 20. Then we split it in half, and it's fine. Just, I don't know, over here. Continuing. Obviously, we don't have enough troops to siege that, but reinforcements are coming. I really wish I had... Oh, all your trade belonged to us. The achievement. I got an achievement with a trade problem. With trade. I don't know what this achievement means exactly. I would have to check that. It was a guy's face looking like a merchant with a robotic eye. Okay, another achievement. Wonderful. Unfortunately, we're not going to get World Conqueror in this playthrough. I would have to start the game as the Ottomans to do that. Sibir. No, I'm not accepting any peace treaties. How are the rebels? Did the Zealots calm down? Yes, they did. Right then. To get rid of this overextension because it's giving us revolt risk. I will start conversions. Because the Orthodox Zealots have disappeared. Let's continue, and when we get to 100 papal points, I will use them to increase our stability. 2+3. How long until the siege is finished? Long. I'm going to ignore the trade company. Because I don't like trade companies. They do give you merchants, but they are annoying. I would like to fight the Ottomans still. Maybe after we deal with Persia, I will actually fight the Ottomans. We still have 10 years, that's a long time in this game. I wish I had more diplomats, though. Okay, a revolt. Where was this revolt? I think it was in the colonies. Well, if the rebels take a province, I will not... Oh, here it is. Good. You guys, use some ships to get to Europe. Okay, let's try and land you over here. You can use automatic transport. Oh, and we did finish the siege here. I'll split you guys up and conquer those two provinces. Although, if the Ottomans piece them out, this will automatically become the siege. So I will take one unit of infantry. Where's the infantry? Oh, it's the top. At the top, as always. Yeah. And station it in Mosul just to prevent it into de-sieging those neighboring provinces. And we can go and siege another fort. Persia is slowly falling to our mighty forces. What is that? That's Yarkand. So I am fighting Yarkand after all. Okay, good to know. Can I detach a siege? I can. Let's go and kill Yarkand then. I will also detach a siege here. 21 units. I will split twice. So we can maintain the composition. This detachment was not a good idea, probably. Yeah, let's redo that. I'll just split them in half. Because the composition suffers when you detach a siege. They don't leave cannons. Okay, then. We can continue. Oh, our power projection is going down. That's unfortunate. That's because we haven't had rivals for a very, very long time. Because nobody can rival us at this point. Lots of things happening. We have occupied this small province here. Oh, the Ottomans are taking this one. Oh well, you can't always get everything. Oh, and you are going to the fort. Yes, that is right. That's exactly what you're supposed to be doing. We'll merge them and... Oh, you don't have enough infantry. Yeah, composition really suffers. I do need more infantry. Let me just... get a new template. Like that. Template something something something. Here we go. That should be enough infantry. People sampling new religions. As always, let them. We are an enlightened community. Religion will not cause unrest in our country. So first we will kill them, and then we move to Yarkand. Can we move there as well? Yes, we can move to both of those places. What I should do is split those armies and prepare a carpet siege immediately. So, select, detach two cavalry, let's say. Split. Same with the other one. That was the big one. Detach two cavalry. Split. Okay, and now we do it like that. First everybody goes to Bukhara, and then we do the carpet siege on the way. Like that. Oh, there's one more province in Yarkand here. Oh, we can deal with that later. Let's continue. I'd also like to conquer Tibet, but that's not a pressing concern. Siege of Bukhara. Oh, they besieged Bukhara. Crap. We'll need to take those provinces again. The garrison was not able to recover, so I should just stay here for now and, you know, conquer it quickly. I should assault if I'm able to. Oops, there's going to be a battle, isn't it? No, isn't there? Don't advance into their armies. Just to wait. Okay, now we can advance. So what else do we have here? So yeah, those armies that were supposed to be Carpetaging Yarkand will instead retake the lost provinces in this area, next to Bukhara. Yeah, it is taking a long, long time. We could build some buildings, but it is not a necessity. Also, where are my forces? I did build a big army. Here it is. Yeah, split that. Use as separate armies. And where should I send you? Oh, also, there's one here. How could I forget them? Is it time to conquer Korea already? Or Tibet? Maybe Tibet. Yeah, let's get you ready to fight Tibet. I'm pausing. And we are losing money slowly. Siege of Merv, what is that? Oh, a fort, wonderful. So we'll just advance slowly until we reach this fort. Commonwealth occupied Kwazin, cool. Let's take this one. What is going on with this? Peru treasure fleet arrived, good. Wait a minute, something happened here. Someone signed a peace treaty. Let me see the log. We don't know what exactly happened, but they are no longer at war with Afghanistan. No, they are. Ottoman Samar and... oh, were they annexing this place and they finished it? That could be it. I don't know. Just keep you here. Split you, go there and there. That'll work. You can go to Kumis, Semnan. Semnan is fine. Alright. Can I assault? I can. Let's assault. Wonderful. Kill them. And then move to Yarkand. Tibet is next. Colony damaged and destroyed. Really? Let's try that again. That was unexpected. It usually does not happen. Siege of Tehran is over. Tehran is where? Well, somewhere here. Oh, here it is. A fort. Should I go to Yazd? I suppose I should. Probably. Yeah, if we are to take everything, we should just go one by one. And I could soon declare war on Great Britain, but as I said, I have decided it's not worth it. It's better to just expand into Asia. Any rebels in this area? No. Good thing I left those armies, but otherwise, not a problem. So yeah, Great Britain will be joining the coalition. Let's just hope they don't feel cocky enough to attack. Let's send you to help our ally here. We should send you as well. Battle of Kokand. Where is the Battle of Kokand? Oh, that's okay. You can go to Samarkand. Oh no, you stop. You're gonna lose this. Ah, crap. Maybe not. No, they're gonna lose this. Run. They're not gonna run. Run. We've gained some cores. Wonderful. We've won some sieges. All is going according to plan. Yeah, I did expect to lose this battle. It's unfortunate, but unavoidable. Okay. And Afghanistan is no longer at war with Persia. They took some provinces. That's everything they did. Okay. Can I... Yeah, let's just stay out of... the combat area with those smaller armies. Oh, can't get there. What about this place? I could. Let's do it then. Oh, we could go to Khuzestan. Who was going to Lorestan? You were. We'll send you to Khuzestan instead. Unless there's a huge army there, you should be fine. Okay, great. Ottomans have left the coalition. Really? The Ottomans have left the coalition. I could declare war on them now. I'll go Tunis, Afghanistan, and Marahan. Do I want to declare war on the Ottomans? That would be a nice crowning to the campaign, taking all this stuff and the Ottomans as well. I suppose it would. Oh, and there's a lot of infantry here that's suffering massive attrition. Just distribute them slightly. So they're eating into my manpower reserves. Okay. If I decide to fight the Ottomans, who are your allies? Show me graphically. Tunis, Afghanistan, and Marhan. We are nicely positioned to fight Afghanistan. I suppose we should probably first finish the war with Persia. Although those units that are supposed to go and attack Tibet don't need to attack Tibet. We'll get them here instead. We can't move here yet. I'll just position them near the Ottomans. Like that. And same with the infantry. You can go north. Yeah, we're gonna fight the Ottomans, finally. Frankfurt has left the military coalition, that's good. We'll see how much we can take from them. Yeah, Persia, what are you doing? They're going to Shiraz. It's the name of a nice wine. And the colonies are almost complete. Well, it's going to take him some time to get there and to colonize it. And Bavaria has left the military coalition. That is very nice. I would like to fight them, but we cannot declare war on them while we're fighting Austria. Unless I separate peace to Austria. And then I kept declaring war. Could I take everything from you? How much could I take from you? That is a lot, but I could take that much. It'll be 86% overextension, and we couldn't core everything. Maybe even this. And then we would immediately declare another war against Bavaria. Who do I want to fight more? Bavaria and possibly their allies, which are Lorraine, Savoy, and Brabant. I don't necessarily want to fight them. No, I think fighting the Ottomans is a better idea. And more fun. Here we go. Some more infantry. Occupied Semman. One of you will go here, one of you will go here. And you guys will go... Oh, stop, don't go to Khuzestan. You don't have a general. You need a general to go to Khuzestan. Oh, that's a king. No. We are not risking the king again. Oh, he's wonderfully good. Yeah, let's get you here and then we will attack together. And Savoy has left the coalition. And Westphalia have left the coalition. Great Britain and Württemberg. We could easily attack Westphalia. Württemberg is already fighting us. Great Britain, though... I don't really want to fight Great Britain because it's problematic. And we would need to peace out Austria first. Still, I believe fighting the Ottomans is more fun. We'll just beat them up as much as we can. Genoa has left the coalition. Coalition is disappearing for some reason, I don't know why. Papal State in Venice. Oh, if the Pope leaves the coalition, I could declare war against him. The Knights, Hungary, Trier, Genoa, and Brabant. Because we could stay at war with Austria and declare war against the Pope. Fortunately, that would mean that we couldn't use the papal points for anything. That's not a big thing. And the Pope has left the coalition. So do we prefer to fight the Ottomans or do we prefer to fight the Pope? Let me just see who the Pope is allied with again. Brabant. I don't mind fighting Brabant. And the Knights, Hungary, Trier, Genoa, and Brabant. Yeah, I can see myself fighting the Pope. Should probably wait until we get one more stability from him. Maybe it's better than fighting the Ottomans. Where are you guys going? Yeah, let's get you ready to fight the Pope. We need to beat him up. Yeah, that's gonna be fun. We lost the battle of this place. Okay then. Let's go siege their forts. Although, I should probably kill their army first. Yeah, we can fight on many fronts at the same time. It's not going to be a big problem. They're trying to besiege some of our stuff, apparently. Yeah, you can go fight the Pope as well. And we have occupied Loristan. Where is Loristan? Oh, right, I was supposed to take this army to Khuzestan together. Almost everything in Persia is ours. Occupied Kusim. Can I get there? No, no. Yes. No, no, no. Let's get you guys over here. We should keep this army in this vicinity. The new guys are enough. Yeah, let's keep this army here. I'll send you to Yarkand just to get rid of it quickly. You're going to over there. Go occupy Kulob and Tashkent. Oh, there's a Persian army doing something in this area. I will use this unit to take care of it. In the meantime, you are all going to the Pope. It was a mistake leaving the coalition. You will suffer the consequences. And they're out with the Knights, Hungary, Trier, Genoa, and Brabant. Venice, our brothers and sisters in the faith. Are you joking? Decline. Yeah, the Ottomans attacked them, apparently. I am not surprised. If we have enough time, I will fight the Ottomans as well. Yeah, let's take care of the Persian armies. Are you going anywhere? No, we're just trying to besiege Bukhara. This is a very strong army, they might even be able to wipe them, we'll see. Okay, Yarkand is being sieged slowly. Where did you run away to? Oh, they're sieging our stuff, we need to take care of that. Did I miss any other Yarkand armies? Apparently not. Okay, great. Let's continue. Tons of troops going to kill the Pope. No, no assaults. An assault would be a mistake. No, you can stay. They're gonna get killed if they get reinforcements, and they will get reinforcements. Oh well. I can live with that. They can't, but I can. First need to kill those armies with this large stack, and yeah, we have Captain Diplo. I suppose I could increase my diplomatic technology. We could get some more trade, possibly a bit later. Oh, what the hell, why not? Just so we're not, you know, capped. I dislike being capped, even if I'm not using it for anything important. And I will use this army to fight the Pope's allies. Namely, who was that? Trier? We're fighting Trier. Brabant. Yeah, it's strong enough to kill the army of Brabant, probably. Well, we'll send them some reinforcements. You can go with them. Battle of Uzkend. Where is Uzkend exactly? Oh, we won, really. Not much happening in this area. Also not much happening in this area. What I should do is detach sieges everywhere and go and kill this army that is trying to de-siege the fortress. Let's do that. In the meantime, are we ready to attack the Pope? Not yet. Those 70,000 troops still need to get there. So you have Kashgar. Okay, good. We can move on. Right. And this is the war exhaustion alert is not of any concern to us. Oh, we don't have enough troops to siege that, really? Okay. We'll use the big army then. We need to wait a little while so that is sieged once more. Okay, fighting the Pope is a thing I like to do. Let's merge you guys and move you a little bit so you don't suffer attrition. In the meantime, those guys are ready to fight the Brabant. Oh! Bavaria and Westphalia are fighting. That is weird. Really weird. I mean, there's a huge monster trying to gobble you all up and you're fighting among each other. What is that? Oh, what I should do is detach a couple of small armies. Send the big guys here. Wait a minute, we'll do it like that. And the rest stays here. Also, they will later move into this place. The Commonwealth of Australia treasure fleet. Okay, a couple more days here. Printing press gives benefits, free power. We've lost the siege of Tehran. Where is Tehran? Right, that's this fortress I was supposed to destroy. I mean, conquer. Stop them from conquering. One of those things. But they did not replenish the garrison. Let's just leave one unit here so they can't replenish the garrison later. And chase them and kill them. Go to Uskend. Maybe just directly here. Yeah, it's gonna take some time. They have very good fortresses here. I don't know how they achieved this technological development, but they did. Okay, this is progressing very, very slowly, but it is progressing, which is the important thing. How about the papal armies? They are ready to fight. Okay, let's merge you guys up. Oh, maybe in Firenze. Get ready. Merge you guys up. Get ready. Because you're going to be attacking Brabant very shortly. Should probably... are there rivers everywhere here? Hainaut, Namur, Kent, and Antwerpen. That's Kent, Antwerpen. Yeah, all the provinces that we have adjacent to it. Okay, we'll have to suffer the penalty, which is not that big. Right. So you guys should get ready to be fighting the Pope. We've occupied Kokand, which is the small province. Back to the Pope. Right. So we need a good general. Not the king. Oh, buy a new general. Oh, he's awesomely good. Wonderful. I could split this into two armies so that we don't... Maybe even into four. Yeah, so we could get proper sieging. We'll just attack Rome and then we can distribute them. Time to attack the Pope. Hello, Pope. Oh, no. I should use this first. How are my conversions going? Are we not the defender of the faith anymore? Let's do that. Will that give me enough to buy stability? Should wait for it to finish to buy stability. 95.5% June. I suppose I can wait 3 months. Send another one, sure. To Jafkir Mashan. It will probably not give me enough papal power to actually buy stability. I doubt it will give me 10. Can I move anywhere here? I cannot reach the big forts. I'm just sitting here useless like that. Okay, let's help those guys out. Okay, the Persian war is basically won. We just need to take care of it a little bit longer. Time to conquer the Pope, finally. I have been willing to do that for a long time. We won't take everything from him, but we will take a lot. So, how's the conversion going? June. I can wait until June. Come on, get to speed 4. June. Come on. Alright, conversion successful. 14, yes, I can buy stability. Buy stability, declare war. Reconquest? No. Take capital, imperialism. Genoa will join, and the knights will join, and Brabant will join. I am fine with that. They will not be co-belligerent, so we won't be able to take a lot from them. Oh, we can't move across that. The rest of you will be conquering. Was that Ancona? Yeah. Will he run away? 19th of June? 19th of June. We'll see. Siege of Yazd, sure. So we can finally move to the last stronghold of the Persians that has not been under siege. Right, so this is going to be a very easy battle. They do have decent military tactics, though. But they cannot stand up against... they cannot stand against the mighty Commonwealth armies. So I should probably take some of you to Genoa. Also, Brabant. Yeah, let's go kill the army of Brabant, and then we can deal with the sieges. This has been taken. Are we at war with anybody else here? No. Can I move through here? I can move through Afghanistan, but we don't have access. Okay, I suppose I'll just kill the army over here and then return to Europe, maybe. In the meantime, how are we doing on the paper front? Will you guys go and kill this army over here? Oh, crap, I forgot to regenerate my morale. Well, we do have a huge numbers advantage, so that could be sufficient. And it was sufficient. Alright, go siege Genoa. Battle of Holland. Portugal entered the coalition, which was to be expected. We're not surprised in the slightest. Can I chase the army and catch it? They're going to Limburg. Oh, they're going further. Going to Koblenz. And then to... Ansbach. Let's chase them. We don't know if they're not going to besiege some of our important things. And then to München. And then probably somewhere around here, maybe to the Pope even. I'll just go and chase them. Right, do I need many troops here? How big is the fort? It's not big at all, I can just assault it. Let's do it when we get a breach. Okay, we have wiped the army of Brabant. Time to return to Brabant itself. Oh, crap, Great Britain is sieging it. Bloody Britain. Alright, how many provinces? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Let's split you into eight armies. And yeah, leave that alone, Britain. I don't know why you're fighting everybody. When you have a huge threat like me. But I'm not going to complain too much. Okay, come on, let's assault this place. Quick and easy. Now, go take Umbria. And then, half of you will go here, and the other half will go here. Perfect. Oh, the Pope is attacking. It's attacking Rome. Oh, he's attacking Rome. We need more troops there. Be quick. Yeah, internal conflicts in some country don't interest me. You guys can return, but what should we do with you? Maybe I should just declare war on somebody else while we're at it. It could be Ottomans. Just get you here. Let's just get you here. Hormuz, do you want white peace? No, you don't. Weird. You should. We're so much stronger than you. Right, yeah, Pope. I think we're gonna win this because reinforcements are coming. Come on, reinforcements. Conversion successful. We gain paper points. Not that we care anymore. I'm not going to convert more provinces, it just gives them unrest. And papal points are useless to us now. Mexico treasure fleet arrived. All those treasure fleets. We have... Oh! Oh, right, carpet siege didn't work. When did you get this army? Where did you get this army? Okay, we need to... build an army ready for... conquering this place. No, don't go through here. Yeah. That'll be enough. They're just here to, you know, assume control. Oh, crap. Our king died again. Well, it's not as horrible as it might seem. At least we are not in Regency, are we? Are we in Regency? If we're in Regency, we're dead. No, we're not in Regency. Okay, you can join the army. And chase Brabant. We've occupied Loon and Breda. Good. You can join in the chase. Come on, finish that. Oh, it was automatically besieged. Of course it was. Okay, sieging Brabant. Mm-hmm. And Great Britain is sending troops. They are the siege leader in this one, but, well, it doesn't matter that much, I suppose. Alright, we beat the Pope. Let's just stay here and siege. This is a very small... You know what? I will assault Rome. Why wouldn't I? Oh, for example, because I lost all my infantry. I suppose that was a good reason not to do it. Right, let's take Umbria. In the meantime, what else do we have here? Westphalia, Hungary, missions, nothing important, allies with Congo. Which is not going to happen because we're in offensive wars, multiple. Right, it's enough for this episode. Thank you very much for watching, and in the next one we're going to completely siege the Pope. And also, maybe take stuff from Brabant as well. Are we at war with anybody else? No. So I will also probably attack the Ottomans. Okay, thanks for watching. I'll see you soon. Goodbye.